We welcome Honorable Mr. Justice T.S. Thakur, former Chief Justice of India, Honorable Mr. Justice Vijayendra Jain, former Chief Justice Punjab and Haryana, and Acting Chief Justice of Delhi. Welcome you all today on this occasion of the seminar, Independence of Judiciary, a Nationalist Perspective. Perhaps Justice Gambhir thought that this is the most appropriate time to have a discussion on this topic when the country is ripe, thinking over afresh regarding the independence in all its facets, including the judiciary. I would now request Honorable Mr. Justice Kailash Gambhir, founder patron of the Global Jurist, to introduce the topic.
Honorable Justice T.S. Thakur, former Chief Justice of India. Honorable Justice Vijayendra Jain.
The debate started whether they should have come like this for the first time, why these judges come in the open. Some said that, oh, what a great, these are the most conscientious judges. They have revolted, they have come up to highlight these issues, what they are facing. What I am saying is, no doubt, the issues which they have raised, they were facing it. Because prior to that, they had written a letter to the Honorable Chief Justice of India. 2 months prior to that. But Chief Justice is not responding. This was so unfortunate. Why the head of the institution should not respond to your senior judges? They're the most distinguished judges. They're the members of the collegium. You should pay heed to those issues raised by them in their letter. But Chief Justice is not bothering. And when on that date, we all know for which case they had gone, that case of Judge Lohia, where the government was interested to have some decision on their side. And when they said why this case should go to a judge who is much junior to them, and why it should, and what is the system the cases are being allocated. And we all know, despite all hues and cries being raised, why that case had gone to a particular judge, and then the judge recuses, case comes back, and the Chief Justice of India's bench decides that case. I really wonder, I should not say this, when there is an allegation being levered, Chief, you are assigning this case to a particular bench to have a certain decision on certain lines, then why the Chief's bench only should decide that case? Could have gone to any other bench to dispel that impression. No, I have no axe to grind in this. Any bench can try this. If you have an objection with this bench, tell us which bench it should try. And the way these four senior judges are being ignored, even in the allocation, no important cases which normally should go to their benches are not going. They're not a part of the many important constitutional benches. Now, this fight, which became so visible, Chief Justice of India on one side, the four judges on the other side. How shocking it is. We can't put our house in order. Who will do it? The forces will come from outside to do it. This has never happened. I am not much commenting. I personally speaking, you ask me, I say that these judges should not have come out in the media. Because by your coming, certainly the credibility of the institution has gone down. And further, it has given fodder to the political parties to bring impeachment motion and everything and all that. This should not. You should have taken some steps to involve your own colleagues in that matter. You could have convened the meeting of all the judges. Sir, these are the issues. Kindly come together and let us talk to the Chief Justice why he is not responding. And Chief Justice of India, definitely, he has shown lack of leadership. As a head of the institution, it is your responsibility to respect every member of the judiciary, to take into confidence the senior judges, to sit across, deliberate, and decide the issues. This is not the way you close your doors, Varda. There was one Chief Justice of India, I will not say much, he's no more now. Everybody knows he never used to give appointment to his own colleagues, judges. How you can run the institution when you don't talk, when you don't come across to your own colleagues? This is what is happening. And now, mind it, media is sitting 24/7. smallest of the news immediately comes on the TV. So you have to be now more responsible in your behavior, in your actions, because you are discharging a very, very important function, function of doing justice. That is your first and foremost duty towards the Constitution, towards the people, to impart justice. These are all secondary things, but definitely this appointment of the judges and other issues are equally important. You have to be very, very honest even in your administrative actions. Don't come with any agendas. कि मैंने उसको नहीं लाना है, उसको आने नहीं देना, और उसको तो मैंने लेके ही आना है, चाहे वो deserving है नहीं है. That is what unfortunately is happening. Another thing, Manish Shibbad is sitting here. I heard him, and he very rightly said the way the executive manipulates the IEB reports. And this is a hard fact. I do not know what is the solution to this. आपने किसी को अगर इफ द गवर्नमेंट थिंक्स दिस मैन शुड नॉट कम ही डजंट सूट्स अस देन दे विल मैनिपुलेट द आईबी टेल द आईबी चीफ इनकी रिपोर्ट खराब कर दो. मोस्ट अनफॉर्चुनेट देर शुड बी सम अदर मैकेनिज्म व्हाई दिस आईबी बॉसेस दे कैन राइट एनीथिंग एंड वी ऑल नो 15-20 ईयर्स बैक ऑन वन ऑफ द नेम्स आईबी रिपोर्ट सेड इज अ बूजर. And he was not appointed for 10 years. His name was sent at the age of 43. Ultimately, his name again was sent in 53, when he attained the age of 53, 10 years gap. And he is teetotaler, never touched any drink, but that report was carried. This is what our IB is. IB says, koi report aap likhwa le. If you know a person sitting there, koi koi Stephenian or modern ka hoga, chale jaiye sir, ye kar raha hai, isko nahi banne dena. तो ठीक है जी नहीं बनेगा वो. दिस शुड नॉट हैपन. वी शुड ब्रिंग सम इम्प्रूवमेंट्स इन द सिस्टम. आई नो जस्ट जनरल जैन हैज टू गो एंड आई विल कट शॉर्ट माय स्पीच एंड विल रीड जस्ट वन पैराग्राफ ऑफ माय स्पीच एंड देन आई विल फिनिश दी. जुडिशरी सेट टू बी द लास्ट बेस्टियन ऑफ होप्स एंड एस्पिरेशंस ऑफ द पीपल एंड द फेथ ऑफ द मिलियंस ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ दिस कंट्री इज शेकन or eroded in the judiciary, then the democracy will be at peril. Let us all work in unison, not only to see that this pillar of judiciary remains firm and strong. To the forces whosoever mighty and powerful may be, they are not liable to shake it or create any kind of cracks or ripples in it. For the first, the judges must sink all their differences, shed their egos, biases and prejudices for each other, and resolve all their internal issues through discussion and deliberations, and tell the world that none can dare to question the honesty and credibility of this great institution of judiciary. Second important is the bar, who has always stood for the rule of law, to play an effective role as and when there is an attack on the independence, impartiality, and dignity of the institution, as our parliament comprises of the bar and the bench. We don't, but the Rajya Sabha, Lok Sabha is not our parliament. Our parliament is bar and bench. Every issue, if we feel, first the judges should resolve internally, but if there is any issue, the bar should be taken into confidence. How to resolve that? It will be a sad day when people will start equating the judiciary with other constitutional bodies who often fall prey to the dictates of the government of the day. Let us not add fire to the fuel and see to it that the independence of the judiciary remains sacrosanct and imperious. With these words, I will just read a couplet, because Justice Thakur is here, so I thought one couplet has to be there. Main in bepana andheron ko subah kaise kahun? Main in bepana andheron ko subah kaise kahun? Main in nazaron ka andha tamashbin to nahi. Thank you very much.